pretty good news as we make our way throughout the evening hours. Temperatures not near as bad as what we saw yesterday. Partly cloudy skies setting up by 9 p.m. The temperature around 85 degrees. That heat index, though, still around 93 either way. Much better than this time yesterday. Here's a story right now. A live look at Super Doppler 7 radar shows a few showers literally just west of Oakland, Iowa, down towards Red Oak as well. And as we zoom in a little bit closer to the metro counties, just not a whole lot going on. Yes, we have the clouds with us. We could certainly see a spotty shower set up, especially south and east of the metro, but not worried about anything in the way of severe weather for this evening. And again, you kind of just see this little line right here associated with a cold front from Des Moines stretching back through Omaha down towards areas just west of Lincoln. All of these showers trying to move off towards the east. And really what it comes down to is they are very spotty in nature. So spotty showers possibly around the Omaha metro, but a better chance east and south of here. Otherwise, not as hot nor as humid as we make our way through not only this evening, but actually Wednesday is looking very, very good for a forecast. And what it comes down to is our rain chances actually increase as we go towards Thursday. Excessive heat warnings just south and east of the Omaha metro until 7 p.m. this evening. Otherwise, that intense heat really stretches from Wichita to St. Louis all the way down towards Houston. These are the areas that have been suffering significantly from hot weather, not getting a break south of here. 87, not too bad here in the Omaha metro. 94, though, down towards Falls City. Gives you an idea of where the fronts had a bigger impact from the metro back towards the west. It feels like 119 degrees for a heat index down towards Falls City. Now what it comes down to, really you can kind of get an idea of where that front sets up across the region as well. Hot from Salina towards Des Moines up towards Dubuque. Cooler as we go back towards the west. That separation of orange and pink is about where that front lines up. Now as we continue to make our way through about 1 a.m., certainly cooler compared to last night. Temperatures actually getting back down to the lower 70s for tonight. And as we make our way towards 7 a.m. Wednesday morning, partly cloudy skies. Not much to worry about through the lunch hour for tomorrow. Looking pretty good. Partly cloudy and again cooler back into the upper 80s, but not near as humid as we make our way into Wednesday afternoon. Wednesday night towards a midnight Thursday morning. Also looking pretty good with clouds on the increase. 85 degrees by 9 p.m. Partly cloudy. Could feel like 93 degrees though. As we make our way overnight, 70. Not too bad, not near as muggy. And really what it comes down to with a light north wind, it should be a half decent night setting up. A good start to the morning. Wednesday morning, 8 a.m., 71 degrees with 87 degrees by 3 o'clock. And again, not as humid for our midweek forecast. The next 3 days show temperatures locked in the mid-80s. That's not bad. Our next best chance for rain, Thursday. And as we start to make our way towards the weekend, kind of an unsettled pattern. Still some small chances here and there for showers and storms, but that is a much better looking 7-day forecast.
You could really feel the difference today.
And especially, exactly, for the evening hours, fantastic so far compared to yesterday, but think about tomorrow. I mean, our dew points could get back down to the mid-60s.
Oh,
not a bad thing. It's gonna feel much nicer, great. A lot less moisture in the atmosphere.
All right, thanks, Tyson.
You bet.
Thank you.